Welcome back to another episode of On Fire Fishing. On this episode, I'm going fishing again with Cat Ron Johnson, and I'm your boy Joe. We're actually going for Nabetta, so it's basically we go out into a bay or sandy areas, kind of far out, and then make a simple drop rig with two branches, both 30 pounds each, with a small little hook, and I'm either using shrimp or ika or taco if you have, and then you have like a 6 to 8 ounce lead, depending on the drift. And what I do is I'm gonna just drop it all the way to the bottom. You're gonna hit the sand and you just kind of just jig and wait for something to bite. But on this episode, we actually caught, this is a continuation from an old episode that we actually caught a bunch of bycatch. But I'll show you that all bycatch is not bad. Here's a couple of fish we caught and nothing goes to waste. Let me show you how we made it. And in fact, there is no bad fish, remember that. There's only bad cooks. Anyway, if you know how to cook certain fish the right way, you can make almost any fish taste really good. So okay, I'm hooked up here. Here we go. Yes. Here we go. Cap's already got one. See, Cap caught a nice Nabetta. Nice fat one. But he's the man. Look at that. Hold it up, Cap. Here he goes. Nice. Nice little fat one. But sometimes when you're going for a Nabetta or any fish, you end up catching all kind of, you don't know what you're going to catch. That's why it's called fishing. Let's see what I got. Oh, it's red. There you go. That's a nice Moano. So the legal size for this is 7. This is well over that. So I'm super stoked to catch this. And besides this one, we actually got a really, really good size table boss. And in fact, when they're younger, they'll be this yellowish color. And when they get real older and bigger and they actually turn into males, they'll be darker purple. But here you can see the table boss right in the corner of this cooler. I'll show you how to make that coming up right now.
That's crazy.
So here's your hogfish, your Hawaiian hogfish, ava or table boss. So you're going to clean it like any other fish. You're going to scale, gut it, and then you're just going to score it up all the way down to the bone. So you see I'm making the slits, and then you're going to cross hatch it. That way all the chili garlic aioli can soak into the meat and give it moisture and flavor. Okay? So let's go make the aioli. Aioli is basically just a mixture of mayonnaise and some kind of other thing. So mayonnaise is basically, or aioli, or mayonnaise I should say, is just made with oil, egg, some salt, and a little acid, which would be either vinegar or lemon. In this case, the cheap, fast, easy way is just to grab some mayonnaise. I use the Best Foods one. And this chili garlic aioli sauce. This chili garlic sauce, which is selling in any Japanese stores. You think it's hot, but it's actually not hot at all. It's just dried garlic flakes in this chili oil. It makes it this beautiful color. And it really adds a lot of flavor. And with the moisture and the fat from the mayonnaise, it really makes the fish taste so good. So you're just going to give that a little mix. Incorporate it all. So in a restaurant, they will call this like a garlic chili aioli. Okay. Mix that, incorporate it well. Now we're going to grab some heavy-duty aluminum foil. I tend to like to use the heavy tin foil because I'm doing this on the grill, so I don't want it to rip or tear open. Another little trick or help is you're going to actually put a layer on the bottom before you put the fish down. That way, it prevents it from burning, and it'll just be a nice barrier, and it'll be a nice even coating. So now you see me holding it, kind of flipping it up, spreading open all the little gaps that I just made in the fish. You're going to coat both sides and inside. And what we're going to do is just roll it up in a tight pouch. So when you throw it on the grill, it's going to steam itself in its own pouch. I usually have the grill about 500, depending on your grill. Basically, just turn it on high, close the lid, let everything burn off, and then scrub it down. Just throw your pouches right on top. Maybe about 5 minutes on each side, depending on the size of your fish. All right, let me go wrap this up. I'll show you how I do it. So there's many ways you could fold it from the top down, make a teepee style, or you can pull it to one side, which I'm doing this way, and I'm going to start to roll it. roll it over. That way it has multiple layers so it doesn't rip when I'm moving around on the grill. And then make sure that you seal the ends. I do at least like 2 to 3 folds. That way the steam doesn't escape and has a chance to just really cook in its own juices. All right, here we go, set. And that, the other one's a Moano, which I did Chinese style. Yeah, yo, let's go hit the grill. Quick tip for your grill. So if you don't have one of those brushes with the wire brushes, and actually the wire brushes are a little sketchy because sometimes the little wire brushes break off and you could have that in your meat or fish. So what I tend to use is actually I take a piece of tin foil, crumple it up, scrub down your grill, and you're good to go. All right, so let's put that on, 5 minutes each side, and it should come out perfect. All right, perfect. 5 minutes on each side, good to go. Let's take this back upstairs. Oh, let me stop in my garden, let's pick some green onions. You can pick green onions, cilantro, chives, whatever you want, but it's more for color because we all eat with our eyes first, right? So let me go pick some of this and then meet you guys upstairs. Here we go, gang. So this is mushrooms in a in a little jar. So I preserved with its own sauce. So Naomi really wanted me to show you guys how to make her mushroom rice. So you just cook your normal 2 to 3 cups of white rice right in your rice cooker, and then you're gonna add at least 1/2 to 3/4 of this jar. The mushrooms already have a lot of flavor and salt in it, so you don't need to add any more salt. But she also wanted to add wakame to this. So this is a new twist to it. So I said, oh, go ahead. So you're just gonna add that right to the top, as much as you want. So wakame is just a dried seaweed, and this is a thicker one, the one that you usually put into soup, and has a little rice balls. But what she's gonna do is mix it up right now. Well, maybe I'll mix it for her. She's having a little hard time. We're just gonna mix it up. There we go. Actually want to add a little bit more. And when you're scooping, you wanna kinda cut the rice at first and then actually spoon it over, deep scoops and spoon it over. That way you don't break all the rice up or mush it up, I should say. So it'll be still nice and fluffy with all the ingredients still incorporated. But if you guys ever try this, it's a simple recipe, but it looks beautiful on a plate and it tastes great. So if you want to impress your wife or your mom or something, this would be a good one to do. Or even just do it for your kids. All kids like rice. So do this, put a little shoyu on it on your dinner plate and you'll love it. I guess she's not done. I guess she wanted to add all the mushroom to it. So feel free to add as much mushroom or wakame as you want to your flavor preference. And if you wanted to also, you could add some edamame to just for some color. All right, good job, guys. Nomi.
Are you ready for dinner?
Yeah.
Looks super good, huh? Daddy caught all this with our Quran. So what we made was, I was actually going to grill the papito and the lye, but Nomi, what you wanted? So Nomi wanted sashimi, so we made papilla sashimi, lye sashimi, hold on son. And then, but the papilla is good if you let it age like a day or two and it gets nice and soft and perfect. But not to waste, I grilled the rest of it, so there is no waste. Nomi, Chef Nomi, you helped me make the mushroom rice, yes. Right? With the wakame. And this is the Moano. To finish up the Moano, of course we just wrapped it in, to recap, we just wrapped it in tin foil, but we covered it in oyster sauce. And it, just to top it off after it's steamed on the grill, just a little sesame seed oil and a little bit of shoyu right on top. And this will finish it up. It actually makes a sauce on the bottom. This last one here, you know what this is called, Nomi? Okay, this has plenty of names, but here in Hawaii we call this table box. It has that name because back in the day, I guess nobody wanted to eat it, so it'll be fat and happy and just be at always on the table and nobody will eat it. So it's the boss of the table. But you know what? This thing is actually really good eating because it eats sea urchins, crustaceans, little fish, so it makes it super, super good eating. Very much like moo, but people just don't know about it. And they don't really cook it right. So what I did was I wrapped it, I basically scored it the same as the other one, same style of cooking, but I added mayonnaise and the chili garlic oil, right? The Japanese chili garlic oil, which makes it basically a chili aioli. So this is a chili aioli table boss. The fat of the mayonnaise really soaks into the meat and makes it almost like crab. Very, very good. Because you are what you eat, right? So if you ever catch one of these, everybody throws it back. But if you catch the big purple ones, you know, give this a try next time. I think you'll really like it. And not only that, it's a renewable resource. You know, you're not just pounding a bunch of other fish that everybody takes. You're taking something that you think is rubbish and making it really good. So, all right. Hopefully catch you guys on the next one of On Fire Fishing. Remember, fish safe and fish with aloha. All right, guys.
Hey, son, which one you like better? That one? That's good. How about you, Chan Chan? Which one you like better?
This one.
Which one?
This one.
What?
This one.
Oh, your chili garlic aioli one. Oh, it's destroyed. Look at that. Hi, babe, which one you like? It's good, right? And they're both super soft and flaky. It's just, I mean, both are just soft and flaky. But I think it might be just the process too of using the chili garlic oil. And actually, this one has bigger bones, so it's easier to eat compared to this one. Really tiny bones. All right.